people look at me and they say, you're very successful. And I am proud of the accomplishments that I've had. You know, to be the first Latina partner in one of the big four law firms, to be the first Latina from Colorado admitted to Harvard, to be the first Hispanic on the federal district court, those are all accomplishments that one should be proud of, and I am. But as I've grown older and hopefully a bit wiser, I've come to understand that that's not what success is really all about. Success is about giving back to your community. The Arguello Dream Team is probably one of the other things that I am most proud of. It is run by me, and I oversee, now we've grown from about 10 lawyers to 30 lawyers. And we travel all over the state of Colorado. We tell them a little bit about ourselves, where we came from, what obstacles we had to overcome, but that with hard work and the willingness to take a risk and dream big, you can accomplish your dreams, and don't let anyone dissuade you. And one of the stories I always like to tell these students is that one of the obstacles they're going to face is peer pressure, and that is probably for students the biggest obstacle. And I tell them this story about, although I decided to become a lawyer when I was 13, and I decided to go to Harvard, I never shared that with anybody, because deep down I understood that people probably would not understand that. So I didn't even tell my family. So I never shared it with any of my friends. When I was a junior in high school, my English teacher, Mrs. Poplin, who is one of my biggest mentors, decided one spring day she was going to ask the students what they were going to do after they got out of high school. And I'm having this raging debate in my head, and I say, do I dare tell them my dream? Well, they were being so supportive, I decided to step off that cliff, and I did. When it came to me, I said, I'm going to be a lawyer, and I'm going to Harvard Law School. And I was expecting clapping. Absolute silence for what to me seemed like an eternity. I'm sure it wasn't more than a couple of seconds. And then, ha, 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 Chris Martinez thinks she can go to Harvard. And it just was like driving a knife into my heart, because these were my friends. I started to doubt myself. And I started to say, yeah, who do I think I am? How am I going to go to Harvard? And by the time I left school that evening after everybody had left, I was ready to give up on my dream. The flame that was in my ambition was starting to smolder out. Fortunately for me, Mrs. Poplin was waiting for me. And she stopped me and she looked me in the eye and she said, Chris, I know you can do it. And that's all it took. I often wonder to this day, would I have worked as hard as I worked to get into Harvard if I didn't hear that laughter ringing in my ears every day? So that was the silver lining in that obstacle. So I said, every obstacle is an opportunity. What I would like to say to women of future generations is, don't be afraid to dream big.